I love my Maple Leaf fans and Raptor fans. Both the Toronto Raptors and Maple Leafs lost their games tonight. I'm going to start off with the Toronto Maple Leafs lost 5-3 to Ottawa. The Raptors lost 150 to 95 to the Cleveland Cavaliers. I'm going to begin by starting off with the Raptors highlights, and then I'll do the Leafs highlights afterwards. If I don't find the Leafs highlights right now, I'll do them tomorrow afternoon for you. All right? These are the Raptors highlights.
Full kick of destiny. So I'm going to the land of second chances, Vegas.
And this time you won't miss. Get in.
The FanDuel Kick of Destiny 2, live Super Bowl Sunday.
Raptors are 11-13 here at home, 19-33 overall. Currently 12th in the Eastern Conference, four games out of a play-in spot for the Cavs. And found what everyone could do. That's a second consecutive turnover. Scotty B attacking Mobley.
Terrific, right through the chest. Strong take to the bucket.
That's Jack Armstrong, everybody, working a little bit hurt. No load management for Jack Armstrong as Mobley goes in. And they have been outstanding. Here's Garland on the attack with the left. And Darius Garland. Barnes, the three, and it's good.
Good 16 seconds of offense that time. Two guys to the ball. Scotty B, wide open, corner three.
Mitchell, and Donovan Mitchell, that's his first shot attempt. Quickly. And the runner is good, using the Poeltl screen.
And he's so good at that floater.
Poeltl back over to Barnes. Here's Gary the three. It's good.
What a skip pass that time.
6:05 remaining in the first quarter. RJ, no. Scotty, yes.
The weak side activity.
Gary rises up. Three doesn't go.
He wanted that, though. He took that with conviction.
We're tied. JB Bickerstaff. Fourth full season, fifth with the Cavaliers. And Mitchell gets to the iron.
The Raptors had an opportunity for advantage there.
Here's Grady, turn, fire, three. Dick connects.
Look, if he gets open shots, right, it's all about that. He drew the foul there. But for a guy like Grady Dick.
Niang up fake. Niang went for a sidestep walk and then knocked down the three.
Look, he's a little burly when he, but he gets to his places that he needs to get the shot off.
Grady's knocked down a pair of threes. They've made 12 plus threes in 18 consecutive. It's the longest streak in franchise history. Here's Abaji, plus the foul.
Opportunities, right? And growth opportunities.
Garland for the curling LeVert. Way up top and a slam dunk. Mobley.
It's open. It's the guy that sets the screen, right? You pin down, get to the basket.
It's going to be a timeout, Darko Rajakovic.
Hey, I tell you what, Garland, the last two plays.
After he's getting back in transition, Garland finds LeVert. This is what we mentioned, the second unit.
Few years back, 2020, out of Utah State, 60th pick.
Merrill turns, fires three, good. And
well,
they
that's what
are
he does.
Pouring it on.
He is a sensational.
On the inside, shot doesn't go. Okoro, here's Quickly. He's going to pull up, wants a three. There you go. You
know, obviously, Boston is an outstanding club. But this club.
Struce the three.
If you're the Celtics, do you want to play these guys?
Well, it's interesting because, as I mentioned earlier,
and they gone, just like the Celtics.
Since the middle of December, they're averaging 15 threes made. Here's Strews with the slam dunk. Well, you have a team here that is playing at the next level, so it's good, right, for this young team to face this as Scotty Barnes goes right to the iron. Here's RJ attacking, gets right to the iron, plus the foul.
Well, again, I mentioned this earlier, I'm not a broken record. Every time he's had Strews in front of him,
he'll put his shoulder down and get to the iron, right, and then get to the foul line. Here's Scotty B with it. Scotty backing in, attacking. Great job by Barnes, 64-45. Be sure to join us next for At the Half.
An excellent shot blocker at Allen as well. He went right to him.
Mitchell.
Ooh. He can hoop, that guy.
Barnes looks away and then drives and attacks.
Yeah.
Shot clock down. Quickly, here you go, and it's good.
Well, good discipline, because Cleveland took him out of there. Flare action on the left side to drive on the baseline, opposite corner to Quickly.
Strews powers his way in.
That was a nice move right there. He went right at Quickly.
The other way, RJ.
Tell you what, Scotty Barnes has had some nifty passes. His peripheral vision, it's special as a young player.
15-point game.
He processes Mitchell. The game.
Three is good.
He's up the offensive boards for the big.
Allen.
Wow. This is when you get yourself truly back in the game.
Raptors down 15. The three. Mobley, 41% from three-point range.
Don't mention the O'Malley family in Brooklyn. They're not well-liked.
Here's Jakob laying it up and in. All right, Raptors are right there, folks. Locked in against Mitchell. Clock down. Can't get on the glass. Strews. That stings.
Well,
up top. Timeout, Toronto.
I'll tell you what, Garland has had some tremendous hookups to his bigs.
Here's RJ. Good pass. Dick, the three, got it. Kelly Olynyk.
Well, he's been trying to attack Strews tonight. That time, Strews did a good job standing his ground. Nice pass.
Allen with a slam dunk. Brown, Kelly. Scotty, Grady, and Ochai, and there's a opportunity. And a team rebuilding. Second chance. Here's Niang. Three is good. Range 8 points. Grady with an uptick, driving. Oh! What a move by Dick along the baseline. Scotty. Oh, great action. Kelly with the bucket. Sent in the NBA since the middle of December. And you can see why tonight. Devazi, Barnes, here's Dick in the corner. Kelly, the three from Scarborough. Devazi, he's had some good looks. He had to hit a three. Counted in the foul. Tom Scotty. Dinwiddie did some. Here's Mobley.
I predict things now.
Yes, you do. As we head to the 8-minute mark, 17-point game. Okay.
You know, Milwaukee's got star power and all that, but I think that's going to be the big thing, and Mitchell's got to be able to play at a really high level. Are they going to be a whole lot more forceful than they were a year ago when the chips are down? Are they going to be these guys when it really matters?
Kelly, right to the iron.
Get a lot of second chance points against them as well. But a year ago, the Knicks dominated them there. So are they going to be that team where they can close possessions now?
Strews
You know, they got to be encouraged with Strus tonight. He's played, but he's struggled of late.
And making his way toward a triple-double. He's 13, one rebound shy of that.
13, 10, and 8 assists last night against the Rockets.
Scotty to the iron. He's got 24. Talking defensively. Getting behind the D.
That sounded like a broken record. But yeah.
Look forward to it. Here's Merrill, the three. He can do that. And the Cavaliers take it here on a Saturday night in Toronto.
How to get the most of Grammarly free.
It's Kayla on behalf of Grammarly to tell you all about the free version of the best communication assistant in the world. Millions have chosen to go beyond their default grammar checkers and use Grammarly. My cousin Izzy, a graphic designer, is one of them. Izzy loves how quick and reliable Grammarly is at providing feedback. Another reason Izzy signed up for Grammarly is its conciseness suggestions, something she wasn't getting from default grammar checkers. Grammarly.
And Brady Tkachuk in the starting lineup for the Senators. Goals in three straight. Looking to equal his longest goal streak tonight. One team's played twice since the All-Star break. Craig. Now Stützle. Back to Zub. And that pass missed Giroux. And deflects back into the Ottawa zone. Nice on the forecheck. Sabat. Slipped on the play. It goes in front of the net. Nice. Across. Here's Marner, circling around, out in front, shot scores! Austin Matthews is back on the board against Ottawa.
And a good forecheck that creates a penalty. Nides is on top of him, but Stützle tries the pass to the middle, which Zub can't control. There's the delayed penalty, but Mitch Marner takes his time and just shuttles it across to guess who? This is something that they've done so often, and this is a shot that just gets up and over Corpusello's elbow.
Nifty pass by Robertson. Whether or not it helped put the play offside will have to determine.
Usually when teams are going to the offside, you know that their video guys are very rarely wrong on that one.
There's Steve Barton and Bevan Mills. The issue with that is
can't see the puck.
Not sure where the puck is.
At 12:05 on the clock, the play was deemed offside. Therefore, we have no goal.
Nylander coming off a three-point game against the Stars on Wednesday night. Seventh time he's had three in a game this season. Riley ahead, Liljegren. Nice pass by Robertson. Got Riley on the move and puts scores!
For a kick or not, but this play is made in the neutral zone. Nice job of Morgan Riley coming up. And that, Jeff, look at the reaction of Domi. Is he worried? Okay, I should have just let that hit. I don't think that's a kicking motion per se. No question turned it, and he redirects it and watches it go in. And man, when he's
coming out of the All-Star break. Aaron Bertuzzi inside the line. Riley, Tavares, and a big stop by Corpusalo.
First big one, but how about this? Corpusalo keeps it a one-goal game.
Josh Norris for the Senators. Gets it back from Zub, and here's Norris to work. Over the line, he's got Patterson. One stop, Martin Jones. Not ready yet, then not backing up. It's Dylan Mandalese on the bench, backing up. Here's a chance for Shabanian, and Jones able to shut the door as he came to the top of the crease. Nylander shrugs off a check, gets it to Bertuzzi. Tavares in front! And a stop by Corpusalo again off the captain, redirected by Nylander. Corpusalo able to steer that away. He regroups back at center.
Great play along the boards by Claude Giroux, though. Two guys on him, and those are the kind of plays that veterans can make.
Tavares again in front. What another great chance. Start the breakup. Back to Marner off his skate. Turned over. Three on one. Claude Giroux in front. And goal to stop. Another scores. Claude Giroux has tied it.
To fight another day. You don't have to get in and get caught on too much of a forecheck. Instead, it's a trap in the neutral zone that creates a turnover. And how about the old savvy veteran? Gets a third chance on that one. Jones didn't know where the puck went as it bounced through. He thought actually it might have gone behind him. Now all of a sudden it's in front of him. And
I am by your side. I am by your side.
They get you into one of those bets, and that's a great story. And that always brings a lot of laughs to the team and brings guys closer together.
Stepping off there, there's Giroux there. Whether sure. He thought there might be too many men or not.
Yeah, he didn't want to risk it, did he? Made sure he got off.
Here's Pinto, swinging, Tarasenko scores! Vladimir Tarasenko, and Ottawa has its first lead of the night.
A turnover, and now your D gets caught, and a little chip pass there by Pinto. Watch how far that Tarasenko moves this puck from side to side. Goes from his backhand, pulls it across, and Jones can't follow it far enough. It's that quickness of the release. Of
across, and missing that pass was Nyes. To the line, Benoit and McCabe. Here's Marner. Shooting that, it teams direction. Corpusalo had to be sharp on that. Pounded there by Batherson, but skates away from the pressure. And a hit for Gregor over the line. Following up is Domi. Here's Max Domi. A backhand. Got his own rebound in front. And that one covered by Corpusalo.
Coming off a 3-for-3 night against the Dallas Stars. This has been in the pocket all night.
Marner sifts that through. Scores. Who tipped it? Nyes and Domi were in front. And it looks like Matthew Nyes has the equalizer.
He almost thought that Brody wanted to celebrate. Look at his head down. He hadn't scored since December 30th of a year ago. Trying to get off the Schneid, off the faceoff. They'll watch Nyes beats Chychrun just in through the body. And then, oh, yeah, it's just that's a swinging deflection there. As Marner gets it through, it does have a knuckler going there. And that one is through the five hole as Nyes able to get it.
But Nyes with a couple of points in the game, and we're back to even. Here's Tarasenko, who gave Ottawa the lead. Pinto in, and Jones for stop in tight on Shane Pinto. Back to the line, Zub. That knocked out in front. And this by Greg. Pinto after it. Tavares trying to come up with that. A stick comes up high. And Jake McCabe looking for a ball. None forthcoming. There's Zub. Up high, Tarasenko. Back to Zub as he turns away from Bertuzzi. A change here off the bench. Scores! Go ahead, goal. The shot from Kelly. The tip from Pinto in front. His first at home this season.
Pinto as well, but no arm went up, and look at the battle and the bodies in front, and there's Pinto backing away as Tavares is trying to get him out of the sight line for Jones, and that one, well, I'm not sure if it hit him or not. He reacted like
guys, some work to keep it in, and then knocked off his stick and out to center by Norris. Here's Norris picking off a pass at center and attacking. Norris fires, scores. Josh Norris, his first in 15, and it's 4-2, Ottawa.
You know, there's many ways to protect the puck, but watch how he does it here. Just puts it to an area, lifts his stick so those slashes by the defenders don't knock the puck away. And that's such a great little play. Bangs the stick down of Marner to keep control of it.
And you look at the first unit out here, and who's not on the ice? Well, it's Pinto instead of Stützle.
Stützle with 10 last year. Tkachuk back. Here's a shot that rings off the post. A big blast by Shabbat.
It's, are you above Tampa Bay? Are you below it? Can you catch Florida? You know, these games, you just cannot at this point let any points slip away. And that's what's great about the last 2.5 months.
Back to the line, Liljegren shooting. A rebound for Gregor, and he put it over the net. As Korpisalo stands his ground from up top, Gregor, and he sent that off target. Ricochets to Domi, swings it across the goal mouth. Morgan Rielly, there's a one-timer by Robertson. Centered in front, scores! It's a one-goal game, and this one will stay on the board for Max Domi.
Good save by Jones at one end, keeps it a two-goal game. And then Morgan Rielly, using his legs and jumping up, makes the play to Robertson and then follows it up behind the net and just got his head up the whole time. For Domi, he's already outside the blue line, so you can get lost. Get out of the traffic, get that little stop up there. And you can see Batherson went right by him. Domi on the doorstep, and he gets that up just over the pad.
Nylander for Marner. Slot to Tavares. Domi got a stick on that. It'll come to Matthews. Time running down. Nylander can't get it through. It'll be sent ahead, and Brooklyn Greg is going to put the finishing touches.
No, it's just a good defensive play here as Greg gets the block. The game's over. You know the time is ticking away. You don't need that. But you don't need this for Rielly, too. And you got to be careful. You don't take more than just a two-minute penalty. You got to have a better look at how bad it was afterwards.
Lose that. Puck is dropped. They will talk about it. Reeves and Kastlik separated quickly. And that's going to do it.